You just got wrecked.
How many bitcoins does it take to get some goddamn respect in this town?
What's going on, guys? It's K-Dub here with another episode of Crypto Zombie. So today is Saturday. Welcome back to the channel. Hope you're having a great weekend so far. Things are definitely getting pretty intense out there. You can see Bitcoin is at $9,987. We have been bouncing around the $10,000 level basically all morning. Actually, this morning, we did wick down to about $9,904 on futures, but currently you can see we are trapped right around this $10,000 psychological level. But we do know the more you tend to hit a resistance or a support, usually they do weaken after a while, right? And we have been just hammering on this $10,000 level. So I do want to talk about that. How is it going to affect the altcoins? Don't forget, we have Bakkt coming up in just 2 days. This is going to be a very massive move for Bitcoin. We know this. And also, one day later, we have the important SEC meeting that they just had to do the day after Bakkt, right? So I want to talk about all that moving forward, but here's the thing. Even if we do dump, okay, because it's possible, right? We're either going to do three things. We're either going to go up or down or stay the same, right? Chances are we're probably not going to stay the same. We're probably going to have a massive breakout or breakdown. But if we do, by chance, happen to dump to the downside, I want you to zoom out, and I have five bullish Bitcoin charts that I'm going to show you today, regardless of the price action. So I'm looking at it as if we dump, well, better opportunity to accumulate more Bitcoin, because I'm going to show you exactly where I believe this thing is going. Well, you know where it's going, but we're going to look at it anyway, because why not? Also, if it's your first time checking out the Crypto Zombie channel and you're not subscribed, well, what are you waiting for? We do this every single day, bear market, weekends, bull market. You guys know we do this. And also, every Monday is the Ledger Nano S giveaway. All you got to do is drop a comment on literally any video, and you are eligible for the drawing on Monday. So, having a look at CoinMarketCap, giving it a quick refresh live, you notice that Bitcoin dominance is still falling, even though Bitcoin price is having a little bit of a difficulty right now, right? So, scrolling down here, if you do look at the biggest gainers of the day, Bit Capital Vendor, I've never heard of this, $1.4 million worth of volume, okay. Basic Attention Token, Zcoin, Energy, Quant, Golem, EOS, IOTA. But then you're noticing as we get lower, it's very minimal gains, and then most of them are going into the mild losses or actually just in the straight up red today. So that is what I want to talk about, because we are having terrible volume once again on the weekend, only about 504 million for Bitcoin, even less for some of the top altcoins right here. You can see Ethereum's under 200 million now. It was putting in upwards of 500 million when it was pumping. So we do have low volume over the weekend. You can see right here, we've been talking about this for pretty much, I think it's about the past 3 days, 4 days on the channel. We were looking at this potential death cross or bear cross, whatever you want to call it. Well, we did put that in, and notice we had this crazy green wick. We had a wick down here. Basically, we didn't really know what we were going to do. As soon as we put it in, we started going in the red, right? And that's to be expected. Now, doesn't mean we're going to stay down here, but you know, I mean, you had to admit, we kind of knew this was coming, right? So we did get pushed out of the blue box territory or the blue triangle zone. Essentially, I do say that some of this probably has to do with the fact that we did put in the cross. So you can see right here, we officially fell below this trend that was being support. So the next level that I'm looking for, if we do continue to push lower today, is probably around $9,821, only because it's been a pretty decent support here, 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 and when we had that kind of fake out dip over the week, right? So that's why I'm keeping my eyes on that level. Now, we did say that maybe this was putting in a bit of a bull flag, right? You know, we had the pole, and then this would represent the flag. But the problem is that now, if we look at where this flag is, well, we're more than halfway down the pole. So the question is this actually a flag anymore? Because if we continue downwards, I mean, we're basically going to end up where we started. And this really critical level around the 9,900 is pretty much where I'm keeping my eyes on, because if Bitcoin falls below that, well, then we could probably, we might have to change our tune a little bit. But once again, no need to freak out. I am still looking at the 21 exponential, still sitting around 9,300. Not much has changed, even though on the shorter, smaller time frames, Bitcoin's going buck wild sometimes. But zoom out, have a look. You notice we are still putting in an uptrend with a massive consolidation period, a 3-month consolidation period, actually. But fact, the crypto giant in the making is coming this Monday. Now, we did have this parabolic curve that, I mean, I'm not going to lie, you guys, it basically supported us. I mean, if we go all the way to the end of when we drop, it was about 89 days. So pretty much 3 months of support we had during this nice little curve. We recently fell down. There is some uncertainty and we are getting closer to back. But if I do take this out of the way just for right now, you can still see this yellow line is still putting an uptrend support. Even though we are looking at it as a descending triangle, we still do have a bit of an uptrend, which I do consider to be short-term bullish. But I want to show you a few things, okay? Number one, I want to show you this post by Banana Peels 1307. Thank you so much for this. So basically, they overlapped the three bear markets leading into the bull markets on top of each other, right? You can see these are the dates down here. But somebody was actually kind enough to basically zoom in on the consolidation periods, right? So you can see that currently we are, so we are the blue one right here. So you have June 8th, 2011 through February 22nd, 2013, and that's this red. And you can see it put in a consolidation period. It's basically these yellow boxes, right? We had the exact same thing that happened from 2013 to 2017 when we had that massive, you know, 20K all-time high. Here was the consolidation. And then now looking at what we're doing right now, obviously this blue line hasn't happened yet. But even if we were to have that dip, you may have a quick wick. But if you do believe, like I believe, that we are in the beginning of an early stage of a pretty much parabolic bull run, could be some sideways consolidation, but I still think this thing could go for another 2 years if we do really get these legs going, then yes, it's a consolidation period and we may have a rough couple weeks ahead. But after that, I think this guy is going to keep going straight to the moon. My opinion, you know, what do I know? I'm just a guy on the internet. But here are the 5 insanely bullish charts for Bitcoin. And this is from James Todaro. You guys may know him from Blocktown Capital, but definitely stick around for this, at least minimally, because this is definitely going to make you probably not so fearful for the short-term price action for Bitcoin. So number one, you can see Bitcoin, which has been compared to all different bubbles throughout the course of history, looks nothing like Tulip Mania or the South Sea Company bubble, which only lasted an illiquid and brief 3 years. Bitcoin has been growing for 10 years with billions of dollars traded daily. So that is definitely number one. Number two, we have, if you actually, and I've gone over this on my channel plenty of times, but if you dollar cost average into Bitcoin weekly every year would actually result in a positive return at today's price, even if you started buying at the all-time high. Remember we did that the other day? You would still be up like 35% even if you bought at the all-time high in dollar cost average, right? Number three, Bitcoin dominates the best performing tech stocks basically in returns over the past decade, even when giving tech companies a 4-year head start, Berkshire Hathaway added just for fun. Number four, on the scale of global currency, Bitcoin is still super small, just passing the Colombian peso and New Zealand dollar in market cap, and it's still far from the market cap of gold, right? In fact, there's a tremendous room for Bitcoin to grow in the future, and if you do believe that it is the digital gold store of value narrative, well, we have a long way to go considering we're only looking at about 0.01%, roughly, of all the money in the world, Bitcoin. That is a lot of room for growth, my friends. And if you think you're too late to the party, well, rethink again. We also have the final number five, and that is returns of over $10,000 were previously only available to accredited investors and VCs in the form of private equity deals. Whereas now we have crypto, namely Bitcoin, leveling the playing field, allowing to invest basically with the opportunity for tremendous gains. You could see right here. I mean, look at how these, you know, companies grew: Facebook, Uber, Lyft, etc. You know, we didn't have opportunities to get in on that, right? A lot of people got discouraged, but Bitcoin, well, everyone can own some, right? It is the people's money. So essentially, those were the 5 insanely bullish charts for Bitcoin. And if you're not following James Todaro, that was definitely the tweet of the day. So check it out. And yeah, that is basically that moving forward. So the question is, well, I get it. We're bullish on Bitcoin long term. But what about the altcoins? Because Bitcoin started losing dominance a little bit and then it pulled back up again, right? So what's going on here? Was that just a fake out? Is alt season actually starting? Was that just investors trying to squeeze out everything they possibly could from the altcoins before diving back into Bitcoin. Well, those are all actually really good possibilities. However, I do want to point out that the altcoin market has maintained, you know, going upward still. We're still above this purple trend that we started putting in down here. So if we don't fall below this, or at least we don't start putting back, you know, going back below the red trend, which I deleted it because we don't really need it anymore, well, then I would say that that is bullish despite short-term, you know, bearish price action. You know, we could, for example, the market cap could dump down back to this purple line and everybody would go, oh my God, altcoins are crashing. Well, they were down at about a $66 billion market cap and they went all the way up to about an $84 billion market cap. So I think that was some pretty explosive growth over the course of the week. And also talking about the altcoin that arguably has been leading the rally, Ethereum, you are noticing that Ethereum was putting in a nice sort of trend here, and now Ethereum itself is starting to consolidate. Now, is this the end for Ethereum? Is that it? Or do we have to go lower? Well, we do have these moving averages. Ethereum could potentially come down to that $200 level again. However, considering it's been having a decent run, should Bitcoin not massively dump, then I could see Ethereum essentially, you know, pumping up and getting back above this trend. Because don't forget, this is the trend that we're trying to get back above, right? So if we get back above this green line, which today is sitting still around the $230 level, well, then I think that would be massively bullish for Ethereum. But I am keeping my eyes on Bitcoin, because obviously Bitcoin, you know, right now is really the coin that's going to decide short term what's going to happen. And I do actually like Ethereum's chart a little bit more. Whereas, you know, Bitcoin just seems like it's kind of just like giving up. But then again, Ethereum could be putting in, you know, one of those Bart Simpsons. And so do be careful out there. We have seen it time and time again. But I want to end on some kind of like, you know, bullish stuff here. So you have William Mugayer. Now, I'm not too familiar with this guy. He's the author of The Business Blockchain. He's author of The Business Blockchain. So I should check that book out. He seems to, you know, he has a decent amount of followers. He's got 27.6K. But anyway, it doesn't really matter. Long story short, he gave some end of year predictions. He thinks, and keep in mind, by the end of the year, he's calling for $1,000 ETH, $25,000 Bitcoin, $50 Ethereum Classic, $20 Cosmos, Binance 50, Polkadot 250, EOS 7, KIN 0.001 cents, and a few others in here. Total market cap, he's calling for $750 billion, with Bitcoin dominance falling down to about 55%, and he thinks that Ethereum is going to have 15% of the overall market cap. Let me know what you guys think about that. So, you know, that's what he said looking forward. But, you know, he did have some pretty good things to say as well. He actually was talking about like what kind of altcoins would be the best altcoins to really look into, if, you know, to invest in during this next crazy bull run for the alts whenever it does start. And he was saying he's looking at certain coins in particular. Now, he says blockchains that have prioritized fast transactional outputs have done it at the expense of network decentralization. You guys know the trifecta, right? So there may not be as much of a reward for those pursuing that, right? He says you should focus on security and decentralization first and then worry about scalability and speed. And this is exactly one of the biggest criticisms about Bitcoin. Bitcoin is slow. Bitcoin is, you know, whatever. Well, it has amazing security and it's certainly decentralized, right? So now all we have to do is work on the scalability. But if you start with the scalability and it's super centralized, you know what I'm saying? So that's an issue. He says, if we wanted just transaction speed, we already have databases. If we wanted a handful of nodes to control a network, we already have cloud services. He says he's bullish on governance-related applications where the underlying blockchain is a platform that is not like a database, not like a cloud, but rather an openly decentralized network that is trusted to enforce relationship logic, transactions, and mediation between parties. So, for example, over here on Hedera Hashgraph, once again, I'm not picking on anything, but you know, like this, I'm just saying this was a super hyped ICO and this is a great case study, okay? You know, I think private investors were paying 9 cents, okay? It's at 4.5 cents right now. So you have, I think private was paying 9 and the token sale itself was at 12. Either way, I mean, you don't have to be a genius to look at this chart, okay? We had one little pump here up to, it was only 5 cents, that was it? Wait, hold on, let me actually zoom out here. No, it's 13 cents. Yeah, that was recent. But I mean, yeah, you could see basically it's just doing exactly what all of them do, you know, 85% down. So this is why I do say be careful. Now, talking about Bitcoin real quick, because I noticed that Bitcoin is the one that's sort of leading the markets. I mean, altcoins had a few days of gains and then now we're kind of just like stagnant again, right? But the thing is that everyone is getting ready for BACT. Everyone's preparing. Not just that, you have miners, you know, turning on their ASICs. You have mining difficulty at the absolute well, not the absolute, but it's very, very, very high right now. You have hash rate at the all-time high, okay? And then according to the CEO of the Devere Group consulting company, Nigel Green, he says that support at the $10,000 level should now be considered the official bottom for the Bitcoin trend. Well, where are we right now? Well, we're below 10K, but keep in mind, you know, I'm talking to you during the day. So right now we're essentially just putting in a wick. When I had made my video the other day, you know, during this crazy dump, once we actually zoomed out and looked at the candle, this didn't even make sense on the chart. It almost didn't even matter. But obviously when you're zooming in and you're just looking at the charts all day, it looks like it gets crazy, but you know, had you just sort of ignored this, essentially you could have just got rid of this whole thing and just followed this trend sideways, right? So that's basically what I wanted to say before I move on, but I do want to talk about the US Congress has set September 24th as a day to thrash out issues relating to cryptocurrency together with the SEC, and you could see they've said that this is with a sense of urgency. One day after backed, okay? So that's why I'm saying next week could get a little shaky, right? Since cryptocurrency has always been a good source of concern for the Committee on Financial Services, obviously this article says it's not a surprise that it is a priority in the forthcoming meeting. So basically, they say that they've stressed the fact that the federal securities laws, according to them, apply to securities which include investment contracts, bonds, and stocks. They don't care if it's digital or not, okay? The hearing is also going to cover stuff like the ETF, the launch of Facebook stablecoin, Libra, which is still trying to come out by 2020. And actually, as far as Libra's concerned, they had an interesting stance on it. They said the Libra token itself may be a security. That's interesting. I think Libra is trying to just be more of a stable token pegged to a basket of fiat, but they say Facebook does not intend to pay dividends, but it's unclear if investors would have a reasonable expectation of profits. So that's an interesting one. Let me know what you guys think about that. But also the CME Group, as we know, they are responsible for the Bitcoin futures and they are cash settled, right? Not physically settled, which is why a lot of people are pumped about backed. But now it looks like they are going to be having some options that they're going to be offering as well. So basically, they say that a few weeks ago, on average, they had around 370 million that was being traded across 7,237 contracts. So this alone has more than doubled in volume this year alone. So if that just shows you some kind of the interest. But yeah, long story short, essentially, they are looking to unveil Bitcoin options in Q1. So there you go. If you don't know what options are, check out Crown. He does a lot more options. I don't really mess with options. It's not really my thing. But hey, if you're interested, there are people out there that can help you. I'm not really an options guy, but you know, there are, if you're interested, you can go check that out. Okay. Also, I just wanted to talk about this article super quick. 5 Bitcoin investing strategies you can use right now. I'm going to drop this below. I'm not going to go through the whole thing, but essentially, you know, they say you can, 5 Bitcoin investing strategies you can use now. Okay, avoid Bitcoin lending, use Bitcoin for collateral, figure out how to time Bitcoin cycles, invest in high beta altcoins, or invest in crypto hedge funds. Not going to go too into this, but it was a nice, it's a good read if you're interested. This was pretty interesting. You have a Russian hockey player accused of $800,000 in Bitcoin fraud. Essentially, he sent a representative or something to go do a Bitcoin transaction for $800,000. It was done in cash. And then the guy that he gave the cash to, who was supposed to represent him, ended up running off. And then they didn't hear from him. So I don't know if it was foul play, but $800,000 is certainly a lot of money to play with, considering you are a famous Russian hockey player. So I don't know the situation with that, but that is that moving forward. But guys, there's not much to say. Okay, everyone's looking at the same charts. Monday is the day we are all waiting for, and Tuesday is the day we have the SEC meeting. So I'm not one. Look, we're back. Oh, are we back above 10,000 again? No, wait, let me go to, not yet. We're trying. We're pushing. What about on some of the other spot charts? Oh, we're above 10 on Bitfinex. We're above on Coinbase. Yeah, I don't know. Right now, we're just still hitting that $10,000 level. It's going to be rough moving forward, guys. It's going to definitely be an interesting time. But that is it for me today, guys, because it is the weekend. Why are we staring at these charts? We know Bitcoin's going to have a big move. Could be to the downside, could be to the upside. If you've been dollar cost averaging all this time, what do you care? And yeah, I mean, you have an opportunity. You could try some leverage trading, but things are going to get very volatile. And then, you know, wait for those resistance and supports to start putting themselves back in again. And then we'll have a much clearer picture of where this is going. But that being said, I'm looking to get some other opinions on the channel, get some other analysts on the channel. I think it'd be fun to have some other people on instead of just having me talk about it all the time.